having a party. It's my birthday. I can choose the food and the songs, can't I? And the music we put on. Can I choose my presents?
Well, no, because then it wouldn't be a surprise, would it?
I know what you want for your birthday, mate.
What?
You pop your cherry, didn't you?
What?
I say, I know what he wants for his birthday. He needs to pop his cherry, didn't he, boys?
What's that? What's pop your cherry?
Think.
No.
What have you got that looks like a cherry needs popping? In your knob, mate. Looks like a cherry, doesn't it?
Rude.
Needs popping, up a woman. Isn't it, boys? The end of his knob looks like a cherry needs popping up a woman, yeah?
I've got an old walnut, if anybody's interested.
So I don't know, Derek's 50. He's older than me. Do you know how much older? 10 years. He's 10 years older than me. You'd never guess. And that niggles away at me a little bit. He's 10 years old, but he's younger in the head, you see, no stress.
Music, Robbie Williams.
Yeah.
JLS, Susan Boyle, Stacy Solomon. That reminds me. Sausage rolls, vol-au-vents, chicken kievs, mini quiches.
Hang on a minute, Derek, slow down a minute. Sausage rolls.
Just shat myself. Meeting's over.
Oh, disgusting.
Let me have the keys, mate. Let me have the keys to the flat. Change the old trousers. See you guys.
Interesting circle of friends, haven't I? Yeah. It's weird because I'm not proud of me, you know, my own life. I haven't done anything special. I haven't sort of achieved anything. But I can say on my mother's life, I have never shat my pants.
That's a new lady starting work here today. Well, she's not starting work here. She's got to do community service because she broke the law. Nothing bad. She didn't hurt a baby or an animal or anything like that. But now she just has to work here to say sorry for what she did. Lizzie, why are you standing there?
Where?
There.
Where?
There, where you're standing. You're standing there.
Am I?
Yeah, go and sit down, Lizzie. Go sit down. That's it. Yeah, well, there's a lot of community service people. What? Why are you filming her now? I was talking.
Posh?
I'm not talking to you.
Who?
You. It's ridiculous. I'll show her, man. I'll show her, man. Oh, she's a man.
Okay. This is Derek.
Hello.
Vicky, this is Vicky.
Hello,
Vicky. Hello. OK, you show around and introduce her to some residents, and then I'm going to show her some proper work to get on with.
Yeah.
Okay. He loves showing the community service workers around.
Yeah. I got caught nicking shoes from the shop I worked in. No, there's definitely nothing to nick here. It smells funny as well. I go around spraying my intimately Beckham everywhere. Stops you feeling sick. That's Victoria Beckham's perfume. I think it's funny, like, she's called Victoria, I'm called Victoria, and we both turned out posh, like, and hair and handbags and that, you know what I mean?
Mr. Kev is my mate. He's not a resident here. Too young. Arthur and Jack. Jack, he likes jokes, yeah? He likes jokes. Then, if he likes jokes with swearing and what a racist, then Arthur's your man. All right?
Yeah.
Yeah, come on. Next. This is Joe and Silo. Is he asleep?
I hope so. Oh, Derek.
What?
Well, Joe, mate.
Go on.
No. Bloke walks into his office.
Who?
What?
What bloke?
Doesn't matter what bloke is, just a joke. Bloke walks into his office, said, I keep thinking I'm a pair of curtains.
Is it a stroke?
What?
Sometimes with a stroke, you think things that aren't there, like, oh, I can smell burning toast. There isn't any toast.
It's not a bloody stroke, mate.
Go on.
Focus, please, on the joke.
Yeah.
Bloke walks into his office, says, I keep thinking I'm a pair of curtains.
Yeah.
And the doctor says, pull yourself together, then.
Nervous breakdown.
Forget it.
Alzheimer's.
Forget it.
Alzheimer's.
Forget the joke, mate.
No, it means pull yourself together, like.
Like a pair of curtains, yeah. I pretend to not get jokes because it really annoys him.
What do you do normally then?
What do you mean?
For like a job.
I've got a job, have I? I've got caught nicking shoes.
Well, is this something you'd like to do?
Well, I thought I had to do it.
No, I mean for like a career or something.
No.
Well, what would you like to do then?
I don't know. Kardashians and that?
Brilliant. Right. Let's get you started.
Why have you got a haircut like a paedophile?
Good point. When are you opening your salon again?
Why is everyone weird in here?
I know it's not a great hairstyle. It's not a style. I don't style it like this. This is how it is. What I find strange is the way it's never come into fashion. You know, when you think of all the different things that have come and gone, platform shoes and long sideburns, dungarees, this has never been picked up. No heartthrob in a Hollywood film has ever had this. And I just feel like that just sums it up, doesn't it? I'm sort of unlucky in life. I've got a shit haircut. Forget it, you're not going to get anywhere.
Yeah, I'd shave it off. Or wear a wig if I was you.
What difference would it make to my life? Seriously?
Your head would be warmer.
Good point.
Well, the bedrooms are just through this way. You going to help me make some beds?
Oh, that's nasty. Do you have to touch anything?
Well, yeah.
And do you wear gloves?
What, to change beds?
Yeah, but old people bed, though.
Well, I think it's better to save the gloves for when you're doing the urinals, otherwise you don't really feel the benefit.
For fuck's sake.
Do you watch your parents back like that?
You don't answer back to you, you don't talk too much.
Well, did you used to talk to your teachers like that then?
Yeah, all the time. Dickheads. Except for Mr. Matthews, he was quite fit. But didn't really go to school much anyway.
Well, I didn't do that well at school, really, you know. You can learn loads of stuff outside of school. You're never too old to learn something. Do you read?
Yeah.
What do you read?
Twitter.
Okay, look in, sir. She's not a bad kid. You know, she's just never been told she'd amount to anything. She's never had any role models, like teachers and authority figures. It's all celebrities now, isn't it? And footballers' wives. Still, you know, I wouldn't mind a bit of David Beckham. As long as he didn't speak. You want him to speak. Be mute. A mute Beckham. Be lovely. Oh, fuck. They're having a laugh, aren't they? That is disgusting. So I still bite the end off.
Wow. Where did you get your nails done?
Did them myself.
Really?
Yeah, duh.
You're cleverer than me.
You can't be very clever then, because I'm thick.
Don't think a thick person could do art.
Tea?
Oh, yeah, do you want it?
No, I meant, do you want a cup of tea? Sorry, you're busy.
Oh, yeah, please.
How do you take it?
Two sugars.
Boyfriend?
No, not at the moment.
Not at the moment, no.
You?
No.
Anyone takes your fancy in here?
Not really, no.
Really? I don't know.
No, my husband died when he was quite young, and I never really found anybody else. You know.
Mm-hmm.
50 years old. I can't believe it. I can't believe I'm 50.
Well, 50's young. 50's the new 40.
Yeah.
60's the new 50.
Yeah.
And 70's the new 60.
What's 80?
80's still 80. You fucked.
What about 90?
You don't have to worry about that.
This is 80. Anyhow. Lizzie, you're 80.
Am I?
Yeah.
Why don't you take Derek down the library now a bit early so I can make his birthday cake?
Now?
Yeah.
What? Well,
yeah. I'm just saying, maybe go down the library a bit early.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Get some books out.
See you later, then.
See you later.
Bye.
We need Kev.
We don't need Kev.
What?
We don't need Kev. We should never say that. We don't need Kev for anything. He's never needed for anything. It's a sentence that should never be said.
Kev.
Kev isn't needed. Leave him.
Kev, come in the library. We're going to the library. Take some books back, get some books out. Once a week, and then read them, bring them back. Take them back out again, isn't it? Dougie takes it to the library, don't you?
Yeah, it's just to get them out of the home, really. Some of them don't even bother getting a book. Alice says, you know, get them out and give them a bit of fresh air. Which is funny, really. When you're stuck on a bus with Kev, they're getting very little fresh air.
Wait, wait, wait. Wait for everyone. How big are they?
Some of them get books, some don't. Some just come here to sit down. Nod off. They might as well be back in the home. But then again, you know, when you're their age, are you really going to start reading books? They might not get through it. Anyway, I don't know what's... if there's any books aimed at the old. It's all autobiography, isn't it? Justin Bieber's just wrote one out. You know him? Only about 12. An autobiography out. Full chapter about how he blow-dries his hair. Cooking books. How many cooking books do we need? Are you going to W.H. Smith and look at the book charts? Every one of them's a cookbook, and they wonder why the country's getting fat. Kev comes along, I don't know what he comes here for. Well, I do know what he comes here for. He's looking for nudity. If there's a book in here with nudity in it, he finds it.
Amateur photography. I can guarantee she'll be in black and white with her kit off by page 10. Tits. Bingo. Oh, love. I'll get that out, please.
You can't take magazines out, I'm afraid.
OK. Well, you got a toilet?
Upstairs.
Smash it.
No shame whatsoever, are they? Look at Derek. I bet you he's looking at a book with cats in. Every time he comes there, the same book, the same cats. He's fascinated by it.
That's kittens, my favourite. I love them. I want to... But you've got to be careful, because you want to squeeze them, but you've got to be careful. And I like old cats. I like all the ones in between. I like all cats. Boss-eyed. I like boss-eyed cats. Look, that's what a cat looks like inside. I've seen that in the road before. Except that wasn't there, it was over there.
I'll get a knife for the cake.
Yeah, everyone's got a bit of cake. Oh. Oh. He's only saying that to say cheers.
Thank you.
Would you come to my funeral? Would you cry? Would you feel some regret that you didn't try? Or would you fall apart the same as
been filling in your assessment form. So how do you think you're getting on?
Yeah, it's all right.
Yeah? I put Victoria is a real asset. She learns quickly and she gets on with everyone. And the residents love her and she's clearly a smart and conscientious young lady. 10 out of 10 for effort. Oh, what's the matter, darling?
I've just never got 10 out of 10 for anything before.
Oh, that's silly. Everything's not a test. I bet you're brilliant at loads of stuff.
No one's ever been this nice to me before, either.
Oh, well, you're rubbish then. How's that?
It's not just you, it's everything. It's just nice being here. I don't think I've ever been in a nice place before.
Well, how does that feel?
You don't like it.
Oh, come here. Be silly.
Here you are. Oh, I feel like a right div now. I was wondering if maybe I could, I don't know, come back next week.
What, as a volunteer?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be brilliant.
Yeah?
Yes.
All right.
Excellent.
Prostate.